week. It's going on for 6 weeks. All about Moses, one of those broken, messy people in the Bible, right at the start, in the perspective. And Susan started us off lovely and really nicely last week. And this week we've got Kingsley, who's coming to share on us, share with us about Moses' calling, the burning bush, which is great. So I'm going to invite Kingsley up, I'm going to pray for him, and I'm going to stop waffling. Hopefully you got the three main things. Belonging and serving, free family fun festival, and the outreach intent. Both main things. Father God, thank you for we can gather here today. Thank you that you're always working with us. Thank you for all of the stuff you've done in the worship. And as Kingsley speaks, you will be ready. Would you minister to us, and would you by your Holy Spirit continue to grow?
Let's give it to you tonight. We give you all. We give you
life.
Jesus, I say, you're just our voice to sing it out. We give you,
we give you life. Exodus chapter 3.
We give you, we give you life.
Now Moses was tending the flock of Jethro, his father-in-law, the priest of Midian. And he led the flock to the far side of the Jordan and came to Horeb, the mountain of God. There the angel of the Lord appeared unto him, cleansing the fire. But he didn't wish. Moses saw that though the bush was on fire, it did not burn. So Moses thought, I will go over to the people's strong side. Why the bush has not been happy? When the Lord saw that he had gone over to look, God called to him from within the bush, Moses, Moses. And Moses said, here I am. Do not come any closer, God said. Take off your sandals, for the place where you are standing is holy ground. Then he said, I am the God of your father, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob. At this, Moses hid his face because he was afraid to look at God. The Lord said, I have indeed seen the misery of my people in Egypt. I have heard them crying out because of their slave drivers, and I'm concerned about their suffering. So I have come to rescue them from the hand of the Egyptians and to bring them up out of that land into a good and spacious land. A land flowing with milk and honey, the home of the Canaanites, the Hittites, the Amorites, and all the land with their heights and sides. And now the cry of the Israelites has reached me, and I have seen the way the Egyptians are oppressing them. So now go, and I'm sending you to Pharaoh to bring my people, the Israelites, out of Egypt. And I'll just stop there. If I was to put a title onto the talk or my encouragement today, I would say, what is your response? What is your response? And before I get to that, I just want to kind of establish a new background and pick on a few verses that we already covered last week. So three or two basic principles I want to dwell on before I get to that topic, what is your response? The first principle, which Marcus highlighted earlier on, is that our past failures and mistakes do not disqualify us from the plan or call of God. Our past failures and mistakes do not disqualify us from the plan or call of God. And when we look through the Bible, it is full of stories of men who messed up, who kind of threw everything away and thought, I've messed up. I mean, I'm talking about Abraham. He lied about his wife, Sarah, so many times. He went and had a child with Hagar when God promised that the promised land was of Sarah. We can talk about David, who broke about half of the Ten Commandments. He lied. He was a murderer, he was an adultery, committed adultery, he stole another man's wife, and the list can go on. yet he's one of the most respected revered characters in the Bible. And move on to the New Testament and talk about Paul. He was going around with zeal, enthusiasm, persecuting the church, trying to eradicate Christianity. Yet he became one of the greatest evangelists the church has ever seen. We can talk about Moses. We can talk about, Peter, who denied Jesus Christ, and yet became a rock on which the church was founded. And when we look at the life of Moses, he's not an exception, you see. Because us, a little baby, we are told that his mother hid him in a basket, or wrapped in a basket, in the river. When Pharaoh told all them, they are commanding that every newborn boy should be killed. Pharaoh's daughter found Moses, and she had compassion on him. And as a result, she asked one of the Jewish women to look after him. And that woman ended up being Moses' own mother. What a great story that is. We are told that as Moses grew in that place, one day he saw an Egyptian beating a Hebrew person. He was really, really, really kind of insane about it. And as a result, he looked around, he looked onto the left, looked onto the right, nobody was watching. He decided to take matters into his own hands and kill this Egyptian person and bury him in the sand. So our past failures and mistakes do not disqualify us from the plan of God. Sometimes discerning God's calling usually involves several attempts and failures. And Moses is a great example of this. We've just been told that he has killed an Egyptian person. Instead of dealing with the consequences of this, he ran away from Egypt and became like elsewhere. I just want us to fast forward this for a few years. God is now looking for a man to assign him. God is always looking for a man to assign him. And you can imagine that the assignment has gone out. God is looking for a man to lead people out of this world into the promised land. But too many of them. And you tell yourself, as the secretary of this book, you have received all the applications and all the CV from people. So you get a CV from Moses. I'm not just talking about any God. We're talking about a God, a creator of heaven and earth. The holy and righteous God, the God who, when he was given commandments, included in his commandments, thou shalt not lie, thou shalt not kill. You are, and this person has applied to work for this God. Oh, I don't know about you, but I will write to him and say, thank you very much for applying. Unfortunately, you do not meet the criteria. And I know some of you will do the same. Some of you will even do worse. Not only will you write to him and refuse him, but you probably will write to the police as well to get him arrested. He's looking for a job. He probably end up in prison. God, our past failures or mistakes do not disqualify us from the plans of God.
So you are.
As we thank God, and you are good. The Bible says his ways are good, and his thoughts are good.
You are good. You're good.
Sometimes you will have plans to do this or to say this. But God's plans are different. Because when God looked at Moses,
yeah, you good.
He didn't see just his failures. He didn't just see his mistakes.
We think that we can sing this song, God, when the sun's shining down, when the rain's coming down,
in the valley and in the mountains,
in the desert,
much more than our mistakes
in the still place. We can sing that you're good.
76.
But for you, shown us time and time again, in the cross that you bore, in the grave that you conquered, in the world that you created, in the way you speak, in the way you live, in the way you love, in the way you welcome us into your kingdom, through the grace.
Sometimes when you look at us,
you show.
You see.
Love you, God. We believe this. Come on, you're never.
But God knows that you're never gonna let me down.
We believe it.
Sometimes you're never gonna let me down. You're never gonna let me down. All the things to me down.
Come on.
And how you feel. Stay with them, and Moses agreed and ended up marrying the daughter of one of their priests. And to cut a long story short, it was while looking after the flock of his father-in-law that God called Moses. I said, a single act of kindness can open the door to your calling. I wonder what would have happened if Moses did not show that kindness to the daughters of this priest. I wonder what would have happened if he failed to act in that kind manner unto his daughters. Over his own
Just want to encourage myself.
The journey in 1,000 miles begins with a single step. You know, sometimes we think about all the big picture, all the big breakthrough, but in fact, the big breakthrough is just a collection of small breakthroughs. One single act of kindness can open the door to our home. And I can testify about this in so many ways. I take a particular example that's passing in mind. I used to work in Clacton. When I go in the morning, all I do is just go to the second floor. When it was time that I submitted my resign letter to leave that place, I was doing my job well. But one of the reasons that they decided to reduce my hours and at the same time increase my pay was because the staff felt appreciated because I just said, good morning, Master, how are you doing?
Yeah.
Good morning. I wasn't expecting.
Worship him tonight. Hey. Come let us, let it go. Come let us worship our King.
Do that.
Come let us bow at his feet.
A call from God when he was showing that kindness.
You see
that?
See what I see. Let's see what our Savior has done. See how his love overcomes.
The Bible is full of examples of this.
Just
look at the life of Rebecca. She went to the water at the well one day. And when she got there, she met
the man. You conquered the grave. You freed every captive and break every chain. Oh God,
you have the grave.
We dance in your freedom. Awaken the light. Oh Jesus, our Savior, your name lives in high. Oh God, you have the grave.
Mama, up to the
you've been faithful.
Jesus Christ.
You've been faithful through every storm that you had. You'll be faithful forevermore. You have done great things.
That tomorrow, for the day after, when the opportunity arrives for us, show kindness to our neighbor, to our friends, to our community.
You will do great things. God, you do. God is a great
thing. And the third thing that I want to encourage you is, what is your response?
You
what is your response?
We've
read about Moses, about how God told him. And God is God.
And he's always giving your freedom,
Therefore, when Jesus came into the world, he said, sacrifice and offer. He did not desire, but the body, the prayer, the prayer.
He was ready. That's why we get God to respond to the greatness of who you are, your love, your grace. Hey, one more time, oh hero of heaven, here we go. Oh hero of heaven, you conquered. You free every captive and break every chain, oh God. You have done great things. We dance in your freedom, awaken the light. Oh Jesus, our Savior, your name lifts in high, oh God. You have done great things.
Here I am. Send me to help with the poor group. Here I am. Send me, Lord, to help with the
mountains.
Here I am. Send me
of chains,
to help
Jesus has
with that young child.
Over the grave.
Here I am. Send
sing
me
hallelujah.
To
the battle is won.
stand against our God. God is calling you and I. What would our response be?
The dark tried to hide you and steal you away.
But God's kingdom calling trans credentials.
Death tried to keep you
inside the grave. That's okay. God is more interested in people that are available for you and people that are teachable.
The enemy fought you. He tried, but he lost.
Moses didn't have any experience of leading.
You cannot be strong. Who believes it tonight? Yeah. When we cry, when we cry for freedom, you tore down the walls.
All he did,
you did, Jesus.
Here I am. I surrender.
The weight of our burdens, you carried it all.
What is your response? What is my response?
And our fears and our failures hang dead on the cross.
Yes, yeah. We are aware. Let's take that for
you. You cannot be stopped.
Mover
of mountains,
mover
of mountains, breaker of chains. Jesus has triumphed over the grave. Sing hallelujah. The battle. Nothing can stand against our God. We stand. We stand on your victory. And we shout.